and with a purpose. You are not an accident here on earth. Bwana asifiwe. Wajua kuna watu wanakaa ni kana kwamba wao ni ajali kwa dunia. Najua kuna wazazi wengine wao wanasema mimi sikuwa nimepanga kuzaa huyo mtoto. Nilikuwa nimemaliza na ule mwingine. So huyo alizaliwa wa mwisho. Na wewe ukasikia story kama hiyo na ukaanza kuamini hata mamangu hata sikuwa kwa mpango. So you begin even to think that God had no plan about your life. I come to take away that lie and tell you God has a plan concerning your life. Live like you have a destiny, because God says that he will never forget about your life. He will never forget you. He has written your name on the palm of his hand. Every morning God thinks about your life. Every afternoon, every evening, God thinks about your life. And I want you to be stubborn. Nataka ukae sugu. Amen. Don't be desperate for anyone. Don't nasikia siku hizi kuna sponsor. Mama mwingine akasema yeye anajua sponsor ni mzungu. But siku hizi kuna another sponsors. Let me ask you a question, you girls and boys who are here. Imagine a married man. A married man who comes and tries to tell you that they can take care of your bills. And at the end of the day, they want just to sleep with you. Are they really serious with your life?
No!
You see, they have the answer. Are they really serious with your life?
No!
So why do you give in to such kind of nonsense? You know, it is somebody who is desperate who will give in to such kind of... I don't know how to call it. Because that man, number one, cannot give you a future. Anaweza kukupatia tu pesa ya kununua donuts zile za 5 bob. They cannot even build you a house. They cannot even take you anywhere. What they only want to do it is to waste your life and waste your tomorrow and waste your destiny, and at the end of the day wakuachie ungonjwa. Is that the kind of life you want? Na unaanza kuringia wale wasichana wengine. Hata mwalimu akikuongelesha hata sasa nimeenda ufanyi, maana uko na sponsor mahali. Na unajua hata ukifukuza shuleni kuna sponsor ataenda kwambia, ah, don't worry, money is there. Money is there, but is tomorrow there? The car is there, though it's not yours. But do you have a tomorrow? Do you have a future? You need to be stubborn and know that God created you with a reason. And there is a good plan God has concerning your life. There is a good man. There is a good woman God has kept for you in the right time. Mimi sijasikia msichana alikufa juu yako ana sponsor. Ulimsikia? Ati ama ati chali akakufa juu yako ana sponsor wa mama mzee. Wanaitangwa sugar mummies. Ati akandead. Hujaisikia? Mimi sijawaisikia. But you need to be principled. I was looking at the life of Joseph, and when he was taken to the Potiphar's house, he was there, and the Bible says the wife of Potiphar alianza kumtupia macho ya kumuonyesha kwamba anatuma signals. Unajua kuna mazingine unaangalianga unaona, huyu mwalimu amemaka assignment, lakini vile ananicheki. Hii ni hesabu plus, hii ni chemistry plus. Unaangaliza macho unaona vile zina, unasema wewe. Na Joseph huyo ndio macho aliona. But he told this woman boldly. Though even in fact Joseph was a slave, he could have been a very desperate man. Na angesimama, I was thinking if Joseph could have said, after all, God doesn't care about my life anymore. If he cared, he couldn't have allowed even my brothers to sell me in a foreign country. But he never gave up. He continued serving the Lord. He continued. We all read the records of right of good things that Joseph did. And this woman one day insights, now I'm going to get out of you, lazima. And Joseph said, I can as well leave to you the court and run away. And when Joseph runs away, this woman, she concocted a lie. And she said, this impure boy you brought us, he wanted to rape me. And Joseph never defended himself. He was taken to the prison. And if you read the Bible very well, the favor of God, even in prison, followed Joseph right there. If you want to have a colorful tomorrow, lay aside every weight that pulls you back. Say, I am going to live for the Lord. Come rain, come sunshine. Because I know one day God will reward my good deeds. The Bible says those who wait upon the Lord, they will never be put to shame. When you're waiting upon the Lord, you might look like you are the least. Ama wewe ndio huko kwa fashion. Wewe huko kwa .com. Wewe ndio uelewi. Shule nyingine nikaenda juzi nikaambia wasichana, I've never seen our contraceptive looks like. And then girls like, they were like, no. Because kwa sanduku yao ziko. And I'm not your age mate. Actually, I was in form 408. That's when I did my form 4. So you can tell I'm not your age mate, right? Amen. And they were like, how can it be? No. And I told them yes, and I'm not trying to prove anything. Because you have to define the kind of life you want to live. I normally tell people you are the boss of your life. You can decide what to accept in your life, and you can decide what to put aside. You can decide, I want to live a holy life, and then one day I have a holy wedding, and you can decide otherwise. Nobody will stop you, not even your parents. Your mother cannot decide the kind of life you're going to live. But it is you to choose the kind of life you want to live. If you want to live a clean life, there is a reward for that. If you want to live a dirty life, there is a reward for that. But today I came to tell you, you don't have to live a desperate life. You don't have to live like God doesn't care whether you exist. Actually, God cares so much your existence. Honor if you are son. God created you with a reason and with a purpose. You will walk with your shoulders high. And every boy who tries to stop you on the way. I have more important business to attend to right now. Nasi maringo ni kujielewa. In times to come, mpaka wewe ukikuja kwa hii shule, wajua sijui ni Emmanuel ama with his wife. I don't know whether it's both of them. Is there anyone who is schooling here? But they come from just a nearby place. If they were living a messy life, they couldn't even today come here. Eh? Kama angekuwa na sifa mbaya, leo hata angekuja hii mission, angesema, eh, tumeni watu wengine. But because he knows that he lived well, that is why even he has the confidence to come in his neighborhood school. And you don't want to come like 10 years to come. Unasikia tunaenda Kinango school. And you are like, eh, nimeshikana leo. Kwa maana unajua CV yako kwa walimu ni chafu na ni mbaya. But you want to walk majestically, confidently, 5 years after now the form falls and say, this is my school, because you know you have achieved the best in life. Praise the name of the living God. And you know, the life you will live tomorrow, it will be the result of the way you are living today. If you live like Anchoka, that is what you are going to produce tomorrow. Praise the Lord. But God, who formed you, who created you, he created you with undefined reason and undefined purpose, so that you may serve him. He has not forgotten about your life. You might be here and you are thinking so hard. What will happen to my tomorrow? What will happen to my future? God has your future in his hands. You only need to relax and do his will. Wanasifiwe. Backbenchers, tuko pamoja. Nimesikia tabia zenu zinajulikana. Lakini si nyinyi ni wale wa ile shule alikuwa. Nyinyi mko nzuri, si ndio? Tuko pamoja huko nyuma. Hebu nipungiani mkono. Lakini wamejifunika na tenda hata sioni nyuso sawa. Ama mimi ndio mfupi sana. Eh? Are we together back there? God created you with a reason. He wants your soul. wants your spirit. He wants to rob the whole of you. He wants you to serve him. He wants you to live for him and make a difference and an impact in the society. You are not an accident. You are in the divine plan of God. You are in the divine will of God. He brought you on earth with a reason and with a purpose. And even if you have been living on that life, today we come to pull you out of that life. Because that is not your portion. It doesn't matter how many boyfriends you have had before. Today you are going to divorce all of them. Leo ni siku ya kuambia bye bye. Kwa maana umejua makusudi yako. Leo ni siku ya kuambia kwa heri, kwa heri. Na kuna jamaa ako pale nyuma naona anahuzunika. Ako na tai pale nyuma. Naona ameanza anaenda leo anaenda. Anaenda leo. You must set a standard. Amen. You know, kama unakaa tu mtu tu hivi hivi, kila mtu tu atakuchezea. Hata utakuwa unapita tu hivi chali tu anakushika nyonyo. Manake unakaa hivi hivi tu na kadu kushikwa. Hauheshimiki, hauna value, hauna dhamana. Lakini ukijiwekea standard, hakuna mtu atakuchezea. I don't remember any single boy in high school who ever stopped me to approach me. For what? How? Kwanza waniona wanatokelezea walikuwa, they used to call me pastor. Wanasema pastor, unasikia wananyamaza. Because you must set the kind of a life you want to live. Kama unateka na home na pia na high 10, na mnaenda huko, na bado tena unarudi kwa siri unainua mikono. Watakuwa tu wanakuchezea tu wanajua huyu. You can't live like good enough for tomorrow. You know, kuna pasta wetu moja alituambia, even those who do that act, after doing it, hawawezi kueleza ni nini wamesikia. Eh? Ukamuuliza, umesikiaje? They can't tell you. It is a pleasure of 5 minutes, which will destroy your future. Eh? Unaziwa ungonjwa na mimba. Ina faida gani? You have a good bright tomorrow. You have a bright future. You can live well until God himself will bless you. God is a rewarder. God is not a robber. He will surely reward you. And you know what makes us to live a careless life? It is that lie I began by telling you. When the enemy tells you that you will amount to nothing, I will amount to nothing. After all, I can just live any kind of life because I will amount to nothing. The enemy comes again and tells you, after all, even if you pass well, you can never go to university. So kurifaisi kwako kunakuwa tu ni kule kwa kulegea kulegea. Even when other students are doing their revision, you are not doing. Not because that you cannot understand, but because you have believed a lie of the enemy. He has told you that you can never make it. So even after form 4, the second month, tunaanza kukutana na wewe. Ati tunasikia umeolewa. Seriously. Ando kwenda college, jamani. Because you had no purpose. Ulikuwa tuko kwa class, unafikiria tu kuolewa. Kwa maana, you don't believe whether God has better plans for your life. But if you can know that God has better plans for your life, you will not rush for things which you are not supposed to be doing at this particular time. Utatoka shule na hata kama hakuna pesa, you will go before the Lord and tell the Lord, God, I know you are my provider. My parents, they don't need to have money for me to be in school. You only need God who has everything to have everything in your life. Stop looking at the people who can take you to school. Oh, my uncle doesn't have this. My mom doesn't have this. You only need God in your life. Because he's the one who formed you. He's the one who called you. He's the one who has better and good plans concerning your life. And that's why he says in the book of Jeremiah, I alone know of the plans I have concerning your life. Your parents doesn't know the plans God has concerning your life. It is God himself and God alone. and you need to depend on that God and go before him and tell him, God, I know you have better plans concerning my life, and I will not live a careless life. And you know, if you live a good life, good things will come your way. If you live a bad life, bad things will always come your way. And you will always blame life. Ushasikia mtu anablame maisha. Maisha imeniendea vibaya. Hakuna maisha mtu inamwendeanga vibaya. If there was anybody to complain in this life, it was this young man called Joseph. Have you ever thought of the life of this young man? Eh? Umechukiwa mpaka na ndugu zako. Watoka nitoke. Hawataki kukuona, wanakuuza. Hata likuuzwa it was better. They were planning to kill him. He's being taken to a house. The woman there has other issues. Wana sifiwe sana. And she lies concerning his life. And he's taken to prison. Joseph had every reason to leave God. Yusufu alikuwa na kila sababu ya kuacha Mungu. Aseme this salvation doesn't work. But as long as you know you are walking with God, God will never leave you. Amen. Wherever you go, the favor of God will always locate you. Amen. Because you are walking right with him. And it is only a matter of time. And the good things will begin to manifest in your life. Wale watu ndio wataanza kusema, eh, na tukiwa high school, she was very serious with the CU. Sasa ndio wanaanza kuona the matunda. Ile ya matunda ya mazao ya ile matendo mazuri ulikuwa unafanya. But by then, hawakuwa wanaelewa. When do you have to wake up early in the morning to go for the morning glory? Awaoni umuhimu. When do you have to fast and pray? But when you begin to see the fruit, they will testify. This was a serious girl. This was a serious man with life. Wana sifiwe. Yusufu akasema, how can I do such a wicked thing before the eyes of my father? Eh? Before the eyes of my God. Wengine watu naongopa watu. Wengine watu naongopa walimu. Wengine ni bold tunaongopa. Eh? Hata huyo kijana akija unamuuliza na nikishika mbao, hata muulizi na Mungu akiniona. Kondani yako kubwa ni mzazi, sio Mungu. And when you treat God like he doesn't exist, that is exactly how he will treat you. But when you treat him like you fear him, you regard him, you recognize him as God, he will always pay you back. Praise the name of the living God. God has not forgotten about your life. Praise the name of the Lord. God always thinks about your well-being. I want to read the last verse as I finish. Verse